Yo, 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 what is going on, everyone? Welcome back to the channel, man. It is your boy Mazir here, and we are back with another Clash of Clans video. And guys, on to this video, I am gonna give you, you know, some reasons. It's gonna be a different type of video. I'm not gonna show you like attacks, I'm not gonna show you defenses, but I'm actually just gonna explain to you why is it important to have your cannons, mortar and bomb towers upgraded first and max them out as fast as possible. So let's just dive into it, man. Let's go. All right, first off, I want to talk about the bomb tower. Well, if you already know, it's completely fine, but if you don't, and if you didn't know by now, guys, if you have super wizards and you're doing a super wizard blimp, if you land on top of a bomb tower and it's level, you know, 14, basically, like for town on 14, I don't know what level that is, let's see, okay, level 9. If you have a level 9 bomb towers and you land on top of it, but you have super wizards which are upgraded, so you can get away with it. Your super wizards could stay alive. And that's exactly why on your defense, something like that might happen. So your first priority, it's not gonna be, guys, multi infernos or something, or expos. Expos are so good, but the bomb tower, the value it gives you is more than expos. The expos doesn't give you too much damage anymore, but a bomb tower can change a whole attack from 0-star to, let's say, 3-star. You know, you never know that. But now, moving on, we have the multi-mortar. Why do I say the multi-mortar and not just the normal mortar? It's because some people might put the mortar on the last of their priority list. But here, guys, if you didn't know, the multi-mortar can actually kill a max level wizard in the 3 shots that it does. So you may never knew about that, but a lot of people, first off, they have their wizards upgraded, a lot of people, because of the color that the wizards have. It's a red wizard now. So if you have a mortar level, you know, let's say what level is that, it's gonna be 14, you have a mortar level 14, it's actually not gonna kill that wizard. So the wizard can actually make that small little funnel, that one building that can do that funnel, and the king or queen, they're not gonna walk on the outside anymore. But if you have it upgraded, some attacker might not know, and accidentally they didn't plan too good, or they just don't take a wizard and they take a baby drag, so now they have less army spots, but they drop something to funnel their heroes or their troops. So if you have a multi-mortar, which is max level, you're actually going to kill any level of wizard, any level of archer, barbarian, of course, and all the other stuff. But that is, guys, the small differences, the small mistake some people might do against your base, which is quite nice, because, guys, there is no point of upgrading a multi-tower inferno or a single tower inferno. There is not going to be any damage. You can even upgrade them later while you're upgrading the cannons, mortar, bomb towers, and upgrade them with books or hammers. Just get rid of them, upgrade them fast as possible, you know what I'm saying? Also, of course, you need the town hall to level 5. So my I would say my suggestion for the town hall upgrades are, if you are already a town hall, let's say for 15, for example, but if your town hall is still level 1 or 2, you're missing out, man. Definitely get it upgraded, you know, buy money, or like, and not money, of course, coins, I mean. So upgraded that to level 3, and then the last 2 levels you can wait on a book of, let's say, building from a gold pass, or you can, you know, just hammer it in 2 weeks, because you have 2 hammer of buildings, of course, in every week. So, you know, that's how easy it is to upgrade town hall to level 5. You need it to level 5 because the damage, guys, it does, and the bomb it explodes, and do not forget, it has an extra range of the poison when the poison drops when the town hall is there. Now, moving on, we have the cannon. There is a reason why I say, literally, on my other account, I'm actually upgrading all of my cannons. And, you know, I upgraded the bomb towers first, but I'm upgrading the cannons now. And that is simply because of the Royal Champion ability. Guys, the Royal Champion, her ability on the level 35 can actually kill the cannon of the Town Hall 14 with one shot. So a lot, and I mean it, a lot of the people do not have their cannons upgraded, neither in Legends nor in War. Nowhere you can see a maxed cannon from a base that is not maxed itself. A lot of the bases are maxed, so they have max cannons, that's fine. But if the base is normal, if even your base, I bet you have not done a single cannon on your base. I can tell you that, because I know. And that's a mistake, because everyone is upgrading the Royal Champion to level 35. For example, even myself, on all my other accounts, I upgraded, you know, Royal Champion to level 35 first, and then the Warden, and then the queen, of course, so we can get all these values together. But the royal champion level 35 can one shot that cannon, and it's a problem. That can actually triple, you know, that can triple you so nicely. But if the royal champion ability doesn't kill the cannon, think about if there is three, you know, cannons left at the end of an attack. What happens if the royal champion takes them out? Well, there is nothing left of that base, right? There is no defense left. But if the champion ability goes and doesn't kill those cannons, and her HP is a bit low, or there is one skelly trap or two giant bombs or something that can annoy the royal champion for a bit, those three cannons can be so devastating, and later on shoot their cleanup, shoot anything else. They are just so nice having that extra HP left in them when the royal champion, the max royal champion ability, basically hit them. That is the reason why one cannon can save the three star guys from your base. Literally can give you the 2%, like it can either give you a time fail, let's say, or it can easily give you a defense with that, you know, not having to go through ability. And that's not only for, let's say, the end of the attack, even in the middle of the attack when they do an RC ability, you're not gonna lose literally four or three of your cannons and just, you know, have nothing to shoot the RC anymore, and the RC is gonna go and grab your multi-tower inferno. You know what I'm saying? You know, you can work that out basically for yourself, but that is for the cannon. Now, why not I, you know, put air defense, wizard towers, archer towers? Because guys, they are not as important. The wizard towers, they are cool, they are nice, they can damage the balloons really nice, but that is the next priority. These are the main priority you should go for. Of course, the mortar, you can just upgrade that multi-mortar, so one of them, and then go to the wizard towers or the air defense. But I'm going to give you a reason why not to go for the air defense, and it's simply because it's value. Guys, the air defense doesn't give you too much value anymore. I'm going to give you two reasons for that. One is, first, of course, is because there is no dragon attacks. There is no attacks too much anymore in Legends as well. There is so much other stuff, bowlers, ground strategies, you know, super, like massive witches. I'm not gonna say super witches because super witches doesn't use too much in the Legends, but hybrid, literally every ground attack, electro titan, anything you can see now is ground. Sometimes you might get attacked with the mass electro dragon, but your base is already so strong with the monolith, with the new town hall level, with the all of those, you know, what do you say, spell towers, everything, you know, together is not gonna let you, you know, let the electro dragons triple your base anyway. So the air defense is an extra point, but you don't need it that much as you need the cannons and the bomb towers. So that's why. Also, the damage of the air defense, you know, that's the second reason. The damage will become like the OG air defense in Town Hall 14 when they nerfed it. You guys remember, they nerfed the air defense once in Town Hall 14 and they lowered the damage. So now when you upgrade this air defense to maxed out, the damage will be the same. So just imagine, there will be literally zero difference because we have a level, you know, a level for the electro dragon basically. So anyway, the base is gonna defend, or the base, if the base gets tripled, there is not too much of a difference one air defense can make. If you upgrade four of them together in the same time and you have so many books and stuff, that's completely fine, go for it. But I gave you the reason why you should not prioritize the air defense in your upgrades at the beginning of Town Hall 15. And of course, we're already a month forward, so I bring this video a bit later, but you know, it is what it is, man. I'm trying my best. Now, talking about archer towers and expos. Archer towers, guys, I'm gonna give you this. Upgrade them the last thing, the last defense on Town Hall 14 and 15. You should upgrade the archer towers because there is zero value. They are literally so dumb. They don't shoot faster, they have not much, too much damage, you know, they don't get too crazy. They just give you the theme color of Town Hall 15, and they still go down to a royal champion of Town Hall 14. Literally, trust me, on level 30 royal champion, the ability will kill them all. So there is no point of the archer tower. But the expo, it's a bit different. So if I would want to prioritize the defenses in Town Hall 15, I would simply tell you, when you are finished with, of course, the monolith and the spell towers, you might not use the invisibility tower too much right now in the meta, but trust me, when Supercell nerfs a few things, which again might be the super archers, might be the electro titans, some people are gonna switch, you know, obviously strategies. So now a lot of bases are gonna switch around, so you might use the invisibility tower more on some certain bases. Right now you have probably a ring style base on your legends, and you have two poison towers, you know, that's just the normal meta stuff right now. It's in everywhere, even tournaments. But moving on to the expo, as I was saying, the expo has a nice priority because when it locks down on a warden walk or a queen charge, It's insane. And if your base has a rage spell, guys, the rage on the expos is crazy. But if your base has separate expos, one expo to the right, one expo to the left, one on top, one on lower, so they are not really close to each other, they're not gonna have that much value, guys. If you upgrade them, there is not gonna be, you cannot see the difference. Let me give you that. You cannot see and feel the difference when you upgrade an expo. That's why the cannon and the, you know, bomb tower, they can be the change of an attack. The expo could also be the change of an attack from, let's say, the 2-star to 3-star, but it's less likely. So you want to have better, you know, advantages when someone is attacking you. And you just have to trust me when I tell you the cannons and the mortar, you know, obviously multi-mortar and the bomb tower, they are just super valuable right now in Town Hall 15. And of course, in any Town Hall level that comes out, make sure you upgrade them before you upgrade the multi-tower infernos, the expos, the normal stuff you usually upgrade. A lot of people, when the Town Hall drops, they go straight to the air defense. There is no point for that, guys. I'm telling you, there is no point. So right now, if you are finishing your multi-towers, you finish with the monolith, of course, probably by now, and you finish the spell towers, go and upgrade your cannons one by one. Upgrade all of them. But that's when, if you don't have the, you know, obviously you have upgraded the bomb tower, but do the two bomb tower first. Okay, I'm getting a bit confused. Do two bomb towers, then start all your cannons, and then upgrade that multi-mortar. And then once you're doing that, always have one builder empty, so you can actually, you know, prepare some stuff for the walls. I would say, like, you need to upgrade the walls as well. The walls are a really important piece, guys, because you might think, yeah, I mean, the jump spell can be this, the jump spell, you know, on miners or anything can go above it, like, or Lalo or something, it's fine, but that one piece of wall can help you. So start upgrading your walls a bit by bit. You don't have to go crazy. That's what I'm saying. Put one builder empty and upgrade the walls if you get extra loot. But also, that one builder is for the hammers, guys. So you need those hammers, well, to upgrade your multi infernos. Do not put the time to actually upgrade them, because they are so long. And if you don't have a, you know, battle pass or a gold pass or whatever, you cannot actually, you know, just wait 20 days for one multi. If you're not in legends, you're gonna lose one whole multi tower inferno or a single tower inferno on your base, which will be just not good in your defense wise. So that is it for that. You need the hammers to work on the multis or even the expos later on, while your cannons, your mortars, then your air defenses, of course the bomb towers before all of them, and then of course the wizard towers, because again, they are a very nice value. But yeah, that was it, guys, for the video. I really hope you enjoyed it, learned something new, of course, about the defenses. If you haven't paid enough attention still when the Town Hall 15 dropped, if you like this video, give it a like and subscribe to the channel, guys. And I'm gonna, you know, put some videos on the screen right now for you. Make sure you go watch them if you enjoy the titles. All right, hope I see you soon on the next one. So take care and peace.